Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to make a track for Lil B, the bass god. So today we're going to go over breaking like every rule in music theory, breaking every rule in mixing. Lil B gets away with almost every style of music because he came in with no rules to begin with. So it's not such a dissonant music like Earl Sweatshirt, but it's not classical music, okay? So it's not heavily dissonant and it's not fully classical. Somewhere in the middle. Sometimes he uses samples from songs which are very musical. Sometimes he just goes with a smaller, more simple melody. So let's start with the bass. So usually I don't like starting with the 808 bass, but for his style, we're going to start with the bass. And we're going to be breaking a lot of rules. So, you know, if I'm clipping in a sound, we're just going to be clipping in a sound. That's just how it is. Let's go to BusyWorks Beats, open up the 808 Science Drums. Let's pull up an 808 that kind of gives a happier vibe for a dance kind of environment. This has become more of a friendly 808, this kind of filtered sound. So we're not even, well, the first thing we need to do is tune the 808. Let's right click, go to edit. And that's going to pull up Edison, and then we can find out the pitch of the 808. And we have to actually retune the 808 so that when we play our keys, it actually plays the correct note. And this is a mistake I see all the time. People don't, tune their 808 and then they play random keys and it gets very confusing when it comes down to music theory. Let's click the pitch regions, detect pitch regions. So this sample's in G sharp. Let's go back to our envelope. Let's right click on G sharp. And that will tune it to G sharp. Make sure you right click, don't left click. Does something else. So we're literally going to start with the 808. So let's right click and tap out the tempo. So we're at about 130 tempo. I want to go boom, 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 boom. So let's start on C. I'm going to do it in a higher octave so we can actually hear the notes, but then we're going to drop it down into a lower octave. So let's make sure the metronome's on. Now this, excuse me, the BPM's a little slow. Now it's important to actually reset the 808 instead of elongating it. And that's all we have for the bass line. Now what we're going to do is drop this down an octave, hit Control A, Control Down. And that's a nice rhythm we can work with. And that's the focus of the song is the bass and the vocal. Don't worry about everything else. Now we need to find elements which we can stack. So let's go to pattern 2. Let's open up. There's infinite options, but let's open up Nexus because it has pre-made synths, which have a certain kind of vibe to them. Once we open up Nexus, we're going to pull up a synth patch from the plucked. Let's go through the plucked sounds. Let's start with the FM bells. Let's hit Control L, send that to the mixer. And you want to just create a nice contrasting top melody, which won't get in the way of the vocal, but also accents the bass line. So think high frequency. So just a 4-note melody will do. That's why I said we're breaking a lot of rules. You know, some people say, okay, the melody should be longer, but when you're in the dance environment, you know, they're not thinking about which chord's coming next. They're just worried about the rhythm. Now we have a nice lightweight sound. Let's go to Nexus. Let's add a high pass filter and cut out some of those low frequencies so that it's kind of like a whitewash sound. Now here's where we're going to start breaking rules when it comes to drums. Let's go to X Drums from BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's load up snare and M. Now I'm going to crank the snare and try to get more tone out of it by squashing it to death with compression. Let's hit Control L, send that to the mixer. Now one thing I'm going to do is set a limiter so that we're not clipping the sound and clipping the project. And also, now technically some people like to clip on the individual track. and put a limiter on the master. So either way, it's going to be clipping. The sound is going to be clipping. Let's go to our snare. I learned this from DJ Carnage. Go to the wrench tool, turn up your level adjust, and just crank up the volume. Now, I'm not going to do it so exaggerated at first because I don't want to blow your ears out. Now for the snare, it's going to go boom, clap, 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 clap. Let's crank up that volume and just squash it to death, literally. Didn't really do much to the sound. It will definitely do it for longer snares. So I guess this is too short to even really feel the effects of compression or clipping. You can hear it's a little elongated. Now, if you really wanted to take it further, you would turn up your input gain and turn down your output for your limiter to really compress it, but it starts to lose, starts to sound compressed. Add a little more vocal excitement. So I don't know if I have a hey chant somewhere in here. So let's right click, smart find, let's type in hey. Let's hit F3 to find the next. Okay, we do, good. Now I know I have the woo chant in the Kanye West from Beat Magic, the drum kit. So let's go to Kanye West. Let's pull up the woo. Now this one, I don't like to always play out the full sample. Woo! So let's go to the envelope. Let's turn down the attack, turn up the hold. And now we can play it like a stutter effect. So I'm gonna do that, kind of do stutter notes. So you want to create variations as you go. Now this one might be have a little time issue, so let's go into the piano roll, fix those lengths, snap to grid, slide these over a bit. See, those notes were early, let's pull those over. Now they're a little too late. Is good in this case for that type of sound because it brings that little B energy when you say things a little before the bar, you know, that kind of Soulja B, little B sound. We remember when Soulja Boy kind of had that type of sound. Let's add the hey chants. Let's see if we can stack the hays with the woos, the woo chants. Notice there's no kick drum. The woo, I don't know if the woo stacked with the haze are a good idea or not. Doesn't really affect it. Just to add a little more rhythm, and that's pretty much it. You don't want to overly do the music. Again, it's not about the music, it's about the bass and the rhythm. Hey. let's go. Let's add, you know, our own little hi-hat pattern. I'm going to clone this and get rid of that first initial note so it doesn't have that kind of effect. Let's duplicate it, hit shift, left click and drag it. I'm going to turn down the hi-hat in the mix. Add a limiter to the master track so we're not clipping. The kind of pocket is dun, 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 dun. That's where the pocket is resting. Everything around that is creating that pocket. So it goes bun, 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 bun. So that's the pocket. Without the monitor support. Then after you would listen to the track, you would go in and record in the mind of the artist. So I might do that for this track if I have enough time. At this point, it's all about writing that hit hook and then coming up with a nice kind of phrase to go throughout the song, and then naming that song after a celebrity, and there you have it, a beat for Lil B.
Bass. Just because you rapping, that don't mean you ballin'. Bass. Just because you got it, that don't mean you bought it. Bass. Just because them girls flocking, don't mean you ballin'. Bass. Just because you thinking me, don't mean you got it. Bass. Just because you rapping, that don't mean you ballin'. Bass. Just because you got it, that don't mean you bought it. Bass. Just because them girls flocking, don't mean you ballin'. Bass. Just because you thinking me, don't mean you got it. Bass. Young bass guy like A-Rod. Bass. Making hits like a nigga is A-Rod. Bass. Young bass guy with a bass rhyme. Bass. Got your girl on my iPhone and me FaceTime. Bass. Young bass guy with that heater. Bass. Got that 59 spinning margarita. Bass. Young bass guy, it's Bonita. Bass. Got your Puerto Rican girl, my Boricua.
So once you're done these beats, you can send them off to him. And you can get these project files for free if you click that link below or go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Once you sign up with your email, be sure to confirm your email by going into your email and actually clicking the yes, subscribing to the list button. So then you can get your project files. Thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorks Beats. bass.com.